Hi everyone, my name is Kim and I am Barbara's daughter. Welcome to my FlossTube channel. I'm here on Saturday this week and probably every week from now on. It's a much easier day for me to make the time in the morning to record my videos. So hopefully you are seeing this sometime about midday on Saturday if you're watching for it. Thanks for stopping by to see what I've been stitching this week. I have a lot to show you. I'm going to start with questions, and I only had a few questions on last week's video. I did show a jelly roll of Christmas fabrics that I bought to make a jelly roll quilt, and I posted the pattern for that quilt last week, and I forgot to mention the name of the jelly roll. So Pat had asked me what the name was, and that's called Little Tree Christmas Jelly Roll. It's by Lella Boutique by Moda. So hopefully that helps if you're looking for it. Laura asked if I could answer a question about quilting and cross stitch. Is it possible to turn a large Hade project into a quilt? So I have never done that. I haven't actually really turned any of my cross stitching into like a wall hanging or a quilt or anything. You certainly can do it. I think the trick with that though is the whole point of a quilt is that you have a layer of two layers of fabric sandwiching a layer of batting, and you sew those, you quilt them together. You obviously don't want to quilt over your cross stitch, so you would have to add enough fabric around that piece of cross stitch that you could then quilt in that fabric area and not quilt over your cross stitch. So certainly it can be done. It's just, is it going to give you the desired look or effect that you want? So another question I had was from Eva, two questions actually, about the thread drops. Where do I store them after I put them on a ring? Right now they're in a box because, you know, I don't really have a sewing area right now, but once the basement is finished, I'm going to get pegboard and I'm going to get the hooks that go in the pegboard and hang all my rings of floss there. If you watch Sunshine Stitchers, Shelia showed on a video when she was filming from her craft room, she showed she had her floss hanging up there. I'm sure a lot of other people do it too. And Eva also wanted to know if I hand quilt or machine quilt, and I do both. Mostly machine quilting, probably for the past 10, 12 years, because that's what is quicker. And I want to spend time stitching cross stitch. Anytime that I'm hand quilting is time I'm not cross stitching. So it's kind of a battle for where I want to spend my time, but I love the look of hand quilting, and I feel like I have often said that if I was gifting a very special quilt to someone, I would want it to be hand quilted. But again, if you don't have the time for that, machine quilting is beautiful and looks fabulous, so I like both. Finally, Cindy asked, do I dye any of my fabric? And if so, would I consider doing a video? I don't dye my fabric with Rit dye. I have only coffee and tea dyed it. I don't really have a plan to get into that. There's so much great fabric out there already. And I do like the idea of doing it, but the mess and the materials and having a space to do all that is not something I really want to get into right now. So there are a lot of other floss tubers who dye their fabric and offer tutorials on that, so you can definitely find them out there. All right, I had another question, and I don't know if it was, I didn't write it down, so it must not have been on last week's video. Maybe it came up from someone watching a previous video. It was about the brick house sampler that I really need to get back to, and asking what color red I used, whether I was using the called for red or not. Let me just show you the, and I didn't iron this piece, but the red that they're talking about is in mostly in the house. There are actually two reds I'm using, but the main red in that house is Victorian Motto Prim Christmas. And then there's another red that is like in the flowers down here, and that's Crab Apple, Victorian Motto Crab Apple. They look fairly similar, but they are two different colors, and neither is the called for. So I can't remember who asked that question, I'm sorry, but hopefully you're watching and that answers it for you. Okay, I have a lot of finishes to show you. So I'm going to start with this little pillow finish of Whale Watch by Chessy and Me. I just added some fabric down at the bottom, and the same fabric is on the back. And I did kind of what I'm calling the Lori Holt method of covering up my slit in the back, which I made really huge. Normally, you don't need huge felt squares on the back. A small one will do, but apparently I got a little happy with the scissors when I was cutting my opening there. So I put two felt squares there, and I talked about last week's video the fusible interfacing that I use to attach that. And then I just put a bulb clip with some buttons and the 2020 charm on it. So that is all done and ready to put out. I'm putting it out now, but soon to be put away and then put out again next summer. The other FFO I have is Blackbird Designs Summer, Autumn, Winter. And if you follow me on Instagram, which I'll post below my Instagram account in the description box, but I did post in my stories a question of whether or not to add lace to the piece because there's more space on the top and the bottom than there is on the sides. Not a lot more space, but there is more space. So I so far do not have the lace on it. It was pretty much a 50-50 split of opinions. And that's kind of where I am. I'm 50-50. I think this looks great. I also think it looks great when I put the lace on it. So I think I'm gonna leave it like this for now. This is just a frame that I got. It was originally $33.99 at Hobby Lobby, and I had a 40% coupon. It's an 11 by 14 standard frame. So if you're stitching this on 36 count, it will fit in an 11 by 14 frame. I stitched it on 36 count creme brulee by R&R, and I really like the color and just using the R&R fabric I like. What else can I do? Call four threads, and I think that's about it. I thought it would bother me more, the difference in space vertically and horizontally, but it doesn't really bother me. So I'm leaning towards leaving it only because the lace that I have, I don't want to attach the lace like onto the cross stitch fabric, right? So I was going to bring it back around and like lace it or glue it or something onto the back of the cross stitch piece. But then it was kind of, I don't put glass here. So is it going to be loose on the front? I don't know. I think I'm probably going to leave it like this, but I reserve the right to add lace at a later date. But I'm thrilled to have this done. I worked on this, gosh, I don't know when I started it. I'll tell you when I started it because I have it written down right here. Just have to find it. Summer, autumn, winter. Started June 6th. Fully finished today. Well, a couple days ago. But yeah, so it's been a project that I have been working on for a while, and I'm happy to have that done. Really glad that they re-released that. Okay, so those are my FFOs, and then I have some FOs. And now don't freak out, guys. I made some significant changes to some of these patterns, and by changes, I mean didn't stitch parts of them because I was tired of them and wanted to be done. So, Peppermint Pals by Brenda Gervais, totally adorable. If you remember the last time you saw it, probably my whip parade, I had this guy all done, and that's it. He was not holding the basket. So I sat down, I think 2 nights ago, and I said, let me just finish this. So I stitched this little guy here, and I looked at it, and I went, I don't really want to do the bird and the vines all around it. I think he looks pretty cute just the way he is. So that's the way I left him. This is stitched on Picture This Plus 32 count mint. And here's my adorable little snowman and his little basket. You'll notice, maybe you'll notice, that he's supposed to have some branches sticking out of his pants with some berries on them. I did not do those. First of all, because I thought it was weird that he had branches sticking out of his pants, but also because I'm not great at French knots. I did them in the little basket. Trying to zoom in so you can see. They are passable. Really not horrible, but I don't love doing them. So I left the branches out and I don't think it matters. I left all the border, vine, and bird around. I don't think that matters either. He's going to be an adorable little pillow that I'll finish sometime soon so he can be out for the winter. So I really like that. I am going to have two giveaways today, and Peppermint Pals will be one of them. So stay tuned for that information later on. We'll be giving away Peppermint Pals because I don't think I will stitch it again. So I might as well pass that on. Another finish that I had was A Year in Chalk, November. I started, and I don't think I showed you this last week. I started and finished it this week, I think. And I'm totally changing all the colors because I don't really care to stitch on that dark gray or black. So I'm doing this this particular one. All of them are on different fabrics and colors, but this is on 36 Count Pumpkin by XJU Designs. It is so cute and tiny. I used Classic Colorworks Bean Sprout for the green and Victorian Motto colors for the orange and brown. The brown is Oregon Trail. The orange is multi-orange, and I really like how that came out. Originally, I had a yellow in there instead of the brown, and that, although the colors looked good on the fabric, when I went to actually stitch the acorns, I was like, yellow and the acorns isn't working for me, so I switched it out for the brown. So I have two of these done, and 10 more to go. So that is that finish, and then the last finish I have is Lantern Lane. And this is the one that is most different from the charted. So let me show you the picture. I had, last time you saw this, done pretty much the whole house, the tree, this lamppost and tree over here, the gate, and this year box there where it said 2020. And so I only had to do the alphabet, the borders, and the flower pot. I mean, it would probably be like 2 or 3 days more work, and I'm stitching on this and I'm just not feeling it. Like, I've had this for a year or two in my whip basket, and just I'm done, I'm over it. I love the house, it's beautiful, but I don't want to stitch the rest of it. So I'm sitting there looking at it and I said, I wonder how big that house is. I wonder what size this would be if I just stopped here. Turns out it will fit perfectly in an 8x10 frame. So my Lantern Lane is going to look like this. This will fit in an 8x10 frame. The only thing I'm not sure of is kind of big space over here. What I did was I took out the year of the box that said 2020. So I'm thinking I could put my initials and the date here because that would fill up some space up there. I added the bird down here, which was supposed to be like the start of the big flower basket. So I wanted something else down the bottom. So I took the bird that was on top of the flowers and put it down there. I had to adjust the top border, and it is not symmetrical, and that is okay with me. So I just love it. I love the house. I'm going to probably fill in something in that space up top, like my initials, and then I'm going to get a frame off the rack at Hobby Lobby, 8x10. You know how much I love standard size frames. And I'm going to finish that, and that'll be out for Christmas this year. So, I just stitch what you love, right? And if you're not feeling it, do something else with it. Find a way to use it without, you know, slaving over a cross stitch piece that you don't really want to do. This is supposed to be fun, right? Lantern Lane will also be a giveaway at the end of the video, and it would be helpful if I put the paper in correctly so you could see it. So I'll have Peppermint Pals and Lantern Lane, because I will not be stitching either of those again. We'll give those away. All right, so I was really impressed with myself. I finished a lot this week. A lot of stuff was mostly finished, and I didn't really finish it, right, because I just stopped doing it. But I'm happy that I have a lot of finishes this week, and I had a lot of whips, too. Now, I had an extra day, keep in mind, because I didn't film until today instead of filming yesterday. So let's get to some whips. I have been working on 4 or 5 whips and pretty much finishing, working on them till they're finished, for the most part. And that's been great because I've had like a lot of finishes, and as I finish something, I would start another project or work on another whip or something. But I just was feeling when I showed you for my whip parade, that big wicker basket with all of my kitted projects and everything, I was like, I want to get to some of these. And I think what I really need to do is work on something and then put it away. After I've worked on it for a couple days, put that away and work on something else and kind of rotate through all my projects instead of just rotating through four or five. I don't like rules. I don't like rotations. I don't like I'm going to spend this much time on that because sometimes I want to work on something for one day and sometimes I want to work on something for a week. So I like to just pick up what I'm feeling like stitching on. But I'm going to make an effort to pick up a wider variety of projects, which might be more interesting for you because then you'll see more projects. But it also may mean I don't finish things quite as quickly as I normally would. So, case in point, I started Patchwork Pumpkin by Blackbird Designs because I was feeling fall. And this is a tiny little pattern, like a reward of merit pin keep, but I think it's probably in a book somewhere too. I have it in a single pattern. And I am stitching this on 36 count Winter Moon by Zweigart. So it's not a hand-dyed fabric. It's just, a regular Zweigart fabric with some of the called for colors, I'd say about half. And then the others I just pulled from my stash. I love this. This is how far I got. Let me actually put up the picture next to it so you can see. This is something that I worked on for one night. Now, if I had kept going, I mean, I could have finished this week, but I didn't feel like keeping going. So I put it away. And now I'm looking, I'm like, oh, I really feel like working on this again. So sometimes it's good to put it away before you get sick of it. I really was nervous about this border because it looks pretty intense on the pattern, but it's super easy. There's really, I guess there's four colors in it. There's like a greenish gold and then a green, and then there's two of the yellow orange colors in the border. And it really is quick to do. It looks like there would be a lot of color changes, but there's not. So I'm excited about that. But, I'm gonna put it away for a while because this week I'm gonna work on some other stuff, I think. So that is Patchwork Pumpkin by Blackbird Designs. And the other new start that I had this week is I hope you enjoyed World Cross Stitch Day yesterday. And I thought, well, if it's World Cross Stitch Day, then maybe we ought to start something and we ought to start a doozy of a project, right? So I have wanted to start this Manor at Quaker Hill ever since I saw Reese, stitching with Reese, do hers. I love the colors. It looks so much better when you see someone who's working on it on a video than this pattern, which I think is the case a lot of times. I only worked on this last night, so I don't have much to show, but this might be something that I work on again today and maybe even tomorrow, just because I want to get a little bit more done. So I'm stitching on the called for fabric, which is 36 count Legacy by Picture This Plus. Legacy is the color. There's also a brand of linen called Legacy, I believe, but this is Picture This Plus brand in the color Legacy. And interestingly, which I haven't noticed with Picture This Plus that much, there was a big difference in the front and the back of this fabric, as far as the modeling, the splotches of darker colors. And I went with the lighter side on this. Like I said, I haven't really noticed that before, but this particular piece was very different on the front and the back. I am using many of the called for colors, but not all of them. Specifically, the reds and the blue that is in the little lake down there are not called for. They are mostly Victorian motto colors. And mine are a little darker, a little, I guess, more saturated. I'm not sure if you can tell. But there's three red pink colors. And so I substituted those. Actually, I think the called for might be DMC, and I'm using Victorian motto. You need three skeins. Let me double check this. There's Oscar, Weeks Oscar, and you need three skeins of that. And Weeks Sage, you need two skeins of. Those are not easy to find. I pilfered them from other projects in order to kit this up. So I have all the floss I need. I don't like to, when you need multiple skeins, I like to get them all at once so you have the same dye lots. So I'm excited about that start. And like I said, I think I'll probably work on that again, at least today, for a little bit, just to get a little bit more done before I put it away. Okay, other whips I worked on. Christmas Garden by Blackbird Design. Sorry for the terrible working copy of this picture, but I think a lot of people have been showing this, which has made me want to work on it. And so, show what I've basically been working in that top corner. I did go down to the very bottom and turn the corner on that border, but I mostly worked at the top here. So I got a bunch of those motifs done, and I'm gonna put this away. I did my initials too, as you can see up there. There are four spots to put your initials. There are four people in my family, so I said, well, I'll just do that. And then I was thinking, like, does this bother anybody else? So if I put myself, my husband, and my two sons, we're gonna have like my son's initials. I have a Sam and a Steven, so they have different middle names, but they're gonna have an S in the beginning and an L on the end. My husband and I are gonna have an L on the end, obviously, different middle and first initials. But like, does that bother anybody to, when you put your family's initials on there, that they're all kind of the same? I don't know. Then I was like, well, maybe what I should do is put like my initials, my mother's initials, my grandmother's initials, because those are like somewhat different, right? Like my mother, my grandmother, and I all have different initials. And then my other grandmother has the same last initial as my mother, but I don't know. It's probably stupid to be worrying about this, but I stuck my initials on there. Haven't gotten to the other places yet, but we'll see what happens when I get there. But I just thought that was interesting because I haven't done a lot of samplers where I put like everybody's initials. I think on the I did put my initials and my two grandmothers and my mother's initials on one other piece. So because they were all different, that didn't bother me. But just as I was thinking about the initials of the four people who live in my house, they're very similar. So we'll see what I do when I get there. I think that next time I work on this, I would love to get that whole section across the top that done. So the big flower in the middle, and then this is symmetrical. Well, not exactly symmetrical, but you have the other reindeer and you have some motifs over here. So that is Christmas Garden. Next, I worked for like an hour. It's not barely worth showing you on Prim Village. And I will put a picture here of what that looks like, because I don't have my pattern here with me. And all I did was start with one of the colors in a green house. So I really did not make much progress. That's because I wanted a new start on World Cross Stitch Day. So I worked on this on Thursday and then I didn't work on it again on Friday. I'm stitching this on 36 count R and R. I don't remember the color. Let's see if I have it written down here. Yes, I do. But find the page in my book. Total, please. Winter's Brew by R&R. Started this May 25th. Haven't gotten very far. Why? Because I'm not really feeling it. So what I'm going to do, because I had said, well, should I do ornaments individually? Should I do one big piece? Overwhelmingly, people said one big piece. I'm doing them in Christmas colors, so only reds and greens. But I think what I'm going to do is four houses. So two here, then the four quilt blocks underneath it, and then two more houses, green and red, and then I'm going to call it a day and make a cute little stand-up flat fold that can sit on my hutch downstairs at Christmas time. It'll look adorable and it'll have four houses, and I can get that done in a couple more days stitching. So that's what I'm going to do with these. I'm going to pull a Lantern Lane on my Prim Village. So I got to work on finishing at least that one house. Then I'll feel like I could put that away and come back to it to finish the rest of it later. All right, the last whip I worked on was Shores at Hawkrun Hollow by Carriage House Samplings. And I had done previously the top block and decided I want to go down here and do the big double block in the middle. So that's what I did, and I will just show you the big piece first, and then I'll kind of zoom in on what I did. So I did get pretty good amount done on the middle block. Just hold this up here. So got the words, the dolphin, the bottom of the boat, and I'm starting to work on the sails there. So another couple of days on that and I'll have that block done. There's a lot of water under there. So I'm stitching this on 36 count Heartland by Picture This Plus. I'm using the Called For DMC except for the water, which I'm using a variety of different hand-dyed flosses for that. And I haven't decided which one to use for that block that I'm working on currently yet because I haven't gotten to it. And also, I am using the Called For DMC, but I'm not necessarily putting it in the spots that you're called for to put it in. So if I don't like, there was a different gray that was supposed to be for the boat, and I wanted the boat to be brown. So I used one of the Called For DMC that was brown in the boat instead of the gray. So just kind of playing around with the colors, because the colors in DMC look very different from the picture. Whether that's poor photography, whether the picture is done with the silks that are called for and so they just look different than DMC, I don't know. But I mean, I don't mind substituting a color, so that doesn't bother me. All right, so that's all my whips. Next up, I wanted to share some haul with you. So I was just at Michael's yesterday, and these very colorful magazine holders are 60% off, I think. They're normally $20, which that's a ripoff, but 60% off, better. And I got a couple of these because right now all of my patterns are over there in a bin, like separated by designer and file folders, but not the greatest system. And eventually, when I have a sewing area, I'd like them to be in magazine holders. And these were nice colors. So I got five or six of these to hold my patterns. So maybe sometime later this weekend, I'll be working on organizing. I love to organize. So maybe I'll do that this weekend. Jennifer at Whistle Stop Stitcher has some new patterns. There are three of them, triplets. So I downloaded all three. Happy Jack, Scaredy Cat, and Spooky Ghost. Super adorable. And I will link her Etsy shop below so that you can go check them out too. These are the first patterns that she's selling, but she does have, if you go to her FlossTube channel, she does have a link to a Google Drive folder with a lot of free patterns. If you're interested. So check her out. I think these were like $8 or $9 for all three patterns. $8, I think, because they're $3 each. So super reasonable, super adorable patterns, very well done in color and black and white. So if you want some Halloween smalls, I think they'd be pretty quick to stitch up and cute, fun finishes. All right. I am interested in doing Snow Village, which is by Country Cottage Needleworks. I'm just writing down a note to myself to insert a picture of that here. Because if you watch Fat Quarter Shops FlossTube, Kimberly recently finished the whole piece, all 11 patterns as one piece. It looked fantastic. I really liked it. She did it on, I don't know what count, but it was a petit point Aida. So I got 18 count Aida. Because why not? It looks great. Can you tell that's Aida? I can't tell. So, why not stitch on Aida? It's quicker. It's easier. I can still use one strand because, it's 18 count. So I have enough to either do this as one piece or do them individually. And I'll put some pictures here of what they look like individually as well. I'm not sure what I want to do. I'm kind of leaning towards individually because on 18 count, they should be about 3 inches by, like 3 inches by 3.2 inches or something like that. So I feel like that's pretty cute small size for an ornament. Now the middle block, which is what says Snow Village and has a couple of cute little snowmen, you can't do that as an ornament, I don't think. But The other thing I could do is do that as a larger piece, make these as other ones as small finishes, and get something like a window that I'll insert a picture here of what my mom has. And do something like that, where you have a display of the small pieces, and then on the top is the larger piece. So I don't know, I'm leaning towards individual finishes. So I purchased, I don't know what number this one is, but it is the Ice Creamery. And I just got two right now, because let's face it, I'm not going to stitch all 11 of these right now. So why spend the money on them? I got the Ice Creamery and the Frozen Hot Chocolate Shop, basically because I thought they're adorable. I like the colors. The red and the green are what drew me to this series in the first place. They are Jolly Holly and Cherry Tomato by Classic Colorworks. And they're not what I would necessarily say are Christmas colors, but I just think they're super cute. And I mean, I guess this is really more of a winter piece, not a Christmas piece. So like those colors a lot. They also, one of these also uses tea and biscuits. And then the rest of the colors are DMC colors. So I haven't put those on floss drops yet. But I'm excited to give this a shot. I think I'm going to do them individually. I think they're going to be super quick stitches. And then I'll figure out how I'm going to finish them later, right? Stitch them first, finish them later. So I really have enjoyed working on the, what do you call it? Petite point or petit point? I don't know, whatever it is, the dots, the fabric with the dots. I have the brown one that I have some other Christmas pieces that I'm working on, and I've really enjoyed using it. So it looks like snow, right? So it's a good background for this this piece. So that was my haul, part of my haul this week was the fabric, the patterns, the floss, good old 1, 2, 3 stitch, click them all, add to cart, right? All right, next, I had put on Instagram a question. I want to stitch this. Now, I started this probably 2 years ago on 28 count Mushroom Lugana, which is the called for. And I will show you here what that looks like, because I still have several pieces cut and ready for the different pieces in this series. This is Summer Schoolhouse series by Brenda Gervais. This is lesson one. I think there are, I don't know, 4, 5, 6, a bunch of them. And I started this. I did not like it on this fabric. This is 28 count Mushroom Lugana. I was stitching it 1/1. I don't know if I didn't like stitching 1/1. I don't know if I didn't like the colors with this. I know I did not like this fabric. The color of this fabric I did not like. So I posted a question. Should I use like 36 count fabric and a darker color that I like, and it's just gonna be big because this is 1/1. It would be like double the size, right? Well, not quite double, but it'd be big. Or should I suck it up and do it 1/1? And everyone, regardless of whether they like to stitch 1/1 or not, was very nice and said, you have to do the one you like. If you don't like 1/1, don't do it. And they're right. But I don't know that I'm ready to say yet that I don't like 1/1. So what I did was I ordered 25 count Mushroom Lugana. Because I said, well, let's give it another try. It's 2 years since I've tried doing this 1/1. And let's try 25 count instead of 28 count. It will be slightly bigger than the called for, but still a small size. And it'll be easier to see. The holes are definitely bigger. So let me give that a shot. And I ordered a couple different colors of 25 count because I wasn't sure I was going to like, I didn't like the color here. Well, look at the difference in the color between 28 count Mushroom Lugana and 25 count Mushroom Lugana. Fortunately, I really like this color. I like the darker color. And I'm not sure how that house is going to look because it's pretty close, but I said, guess what? I'll just do the house in a different color then if I don't like the way the house looks. Like a blue house would be nice. I could do a red house. whatever house, whatever color I feel like. So I'm going to give this a shot. 1/1, 25 count on this much nicer, darker mushroom Lugana. I'll keep you posted. We'll see how it is. I may start this week because I'm really anxious to see how I'm going to like it. I've had a couple people send me some tips on 1/1. I've watched some videos. I mean, I think it's completely within the realm of something I can do. All of us can do it. It's just, am I willing to, it obviously takes longer. Am I willing to put in the time to do that? And am I going to like the result? So I will keep you posted on the 1/1. I also bought Stormy Clouds Lugana, which does not look anything like what I expected it to look like. There's a lot of white in here, and I thought it was more of an all-over gray. And I was interested to see how the colors for this summer schoolhouse would look on a gray, because this was gray, and I coffee tea dyed it and liked the way the colors looked on this. So I thought, well, I could see what it looks like on gray. It doesn't look good on this gray. Again, mostly because I think it's more of a white with gray modeling over it. But this, I'll save, use it for something else. So I'm excited to give this a shot and see how I feel about 1/1 for real. Let's see. That is all for my haul. So the only other thing that I wanted to show you that I did this week is I made some mask pouches. Obviously, we're all wearing masks. Well, I don't know if you're all wearing masks. Here, we are all wearing masks when we go out. And my mask, first of all, I don't go out that often, but grocery store, you know, if I have to go to work, whatever, you gotta wear a mask. So my mask is either in like a Ziploc bag or shoved in my pocketbook somewhere, which is probably not super sanitary. And my sons are going back to school, and they have to bring masks with them. And so I wanted to make a little pouch for them to carry their extra, you know, you gotta have an extra mask. Like, what if you sneeze in your mask or something, right? You need to have an extra one. So I wanted a pouch that would clip on their backpack that they could hold extra masks. So I made a whole bunch of mask pouches. And there's just a little flap up here, and you put the mask in, and it has a clip, clips on your backpack, or on your pocketbook. And so I posted these on Instagram, and people were like, oh, did you use a pattern? How'd you get this? And yes, I bought a pattern from Etsy. I searched mask pouches, and I clicked on one and bought it. It was like $3. I'm not going to put that pattern in the description box because it was a bad pattern. And when I say it was a bad pattern, I mean, if I did not have what I would say is pretty significant sewing, quilting experience, I would not have been able to figure out how to make this mask pouch. So I don't want to put it out there as like, here's how you do it, and then you buy this pattern and you're like, this is a terrible pattern. Also, when I made the mask pouch according to their directions, this is how small it was. I had to make it a little bigger because you can't fit a mask in here. I mean, maybe a baby mask, but not a full-size mask. So I had to change the fabric. I will tell you that I cut my fabric. These are two rectangles, one for the outside, one for the inside lining. I cut them 7 inches by 11 inches. I cut a little piece of fabric for the loop, 2 inches by 3 inches. And all I did was I took those two rectangles, I sewed them right sides together, turned them inside out, and then I folded the loop over, attached it, then I folded the rectangle top down, bottom up, and sewed the sides. Flipped that inside out and had my patch. If that is, that's not really great directions, I realize that. But what I would suggest you do if you want to make a mask pouch is look for a pattern and just check your measurements on the fabric, because you don't want to end up with a super small one. But like I said, mine was about 7 inches wide by 11 inches tall before you fold it in thirds. So I made a whole bunch of them because I was giving them away to my friends and my family. So we still have some mask pouches there. And so that's what I did this week in sewing. I didn't do any quilting. I still have that quilt top for the Christmas quilt top that I want to make. I did actually machine quilt yesterday, my fall quilt, and I didn't remember to bring it up here, so I will try and remember next week to bring it up and show you what that looks like. I think that's everything. Looking around at the disaster that is the guest room bed right now, I think I have shown you all of it. And so I just want to do a giveaway for these two patterns. So I have Lantern Lane and Peppermint Pals. So if you would like to be entered in the giveaway, just somewhere in your comment, you don't have to put it into a sentence. Just type the word lantern or peppermint. And that way I will know what you're interested in. You can type them both words if you want. And I will do the random comment picker, searching for the word lantern, searching for the word peppermint next time. And I'll just pull a winner on the next video for each of these patterns and send them out to you. So all the standard FlossTube giveaway rules apply. Please be 18. Please do not use the word giveaway or free or anything like that in your comment, or I will have to delete your comment so that we don't get YouTube trolls trying to win cross-stitch patterns and they're not cross-stitchers. Yeah, so these patterns are, I would say, like new. Nothing's written on them. They have all the pieces in them, and I will mail them out anywhere in the world. So if you'd like to enter the giveaway, you can, again, either type in peppermint or lantern for the patterns you're interested in. And I think that's all for today. I hope you have a great week and get lots of stitching done. And I will see you next Saturday. Bye-bye.